Good morning, students. Now we are going to do the question answer of Unit 2, Section C, TPT, The Flying Squirrel. This is for class 7th students. Okay, let's start it. I am just zooming in, okay, so that you can understand it better. Okay, more. All right, now you can see it very clearly. Okay. Yes, so here today we will do the questions which are given in our book plus the extra questions. Okay, so whatever I am posting, whatever I will upload, these questions you have to do in your notebook. Okay, now let's start it. Read to understand. Find out from the passage about the following. Okay, so first one is the color of TPT's fur. So this you have to tell. What was the color of TPT's fur? Chestnut red. Okay, so that can, these question can come in form of MCQs. All right, so the color of TPT's fur, answer, chestnut red. Okay, chestnut red. Second, the length of TPT's tail, 2 feet. Answer is 2 feet. Now see any 5 things that made up TPT's diet. So what was the diet of TPT? Just write there, pudding, PUDDINGS, comma, stewed fruit, okay, walnut, milk and custard. Stewed, STEWED, okay, walnut, milk and custard. Okay, now D, the breeds of TPT's best friends. So those who were TPT's best friend, Don, a field spaniel, and Brook, a large shaggy Tibetan sheep dog. So these were the kind. Okay, Don, a field spaniel, and Brook, a large shaggy Tibetan sheep dog. Okay, I'll just post these in a snap homework also, so that if you will feel any difficulty here, you can do from there. All right, okay. Now question number 2, answer the following question. Describe TPT's little house. Okay, describe TPT's little house. Describe TPT's little house. So answer, she lived in a little box with 2 partitions, PARTITIONS. The inner one, her bedroom, was fitted FITTED, fitted with a little nest of feathers, FEATHERS, feathers and cotton wool, and a tiny door, LED, led from it into the bigger sitting room where she also dined. So this was the description of TPT's little house. Again, she lived in a little box with 2 partitions. The inner one, her bedroom, was fitted with a little nest of feathers and cotton wool, and a tiny door led from it into the bigger sitting room where she also dined. Okay, so complete it again. I'm showing. Okay, okay, now question number, next question number B, what was her toilet routine? So this you have to write. TPT was very particular about her toilet routine, full stop. She would sit erect, 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 and carefully get to work both her little hands, full stop, beginning with the tip of her nose, comma, she would gradually work over the whole of her face. So now we will do what was her toilet routine. okay. B part, Tippity was very particular. Okay, Tippity, TIPPITY, Tippity was very particular, PARTICULAR, about her toilet routine, toilet, TOILET, routine, ROUTINE, full stop, she would sit erect, ERECT, and carefully get to work, both her little hands, full stop, beginning, BEGINNING, beginning with the tip of her nose, NOSE nose, comma, she would gradually gradually work over the whole of her face and head, full stop, the tail would be her last, comma, but by no means her least care. Okay, so this is answer number B. Again, I am showing so that you can do. TPT was very particular about her toilet routine. Full stop. She would sit erect and carefully get to work. Both her little hands. Full stop. Beginning with the tip of her nose, comma, she would gradually work over the whole of her face and head. The tail would be her last, but by no means her least care. Okay, so this is question number B. Now C, which theory did the writer disprove with the help of TPT? So answer, the Himalayan nutcracker had been credited with the holes, one frequently found in walnuts in the Himalayas. Full stop. The writer disapproved this theory with the help of TPT. Okay, so this is answer number C. Okay, you can see here. Just do this answer number C. Okay. Now next. Again, I just want to show this page by just zooming out so that you can just see. Okay, again I'm doing. All right, one more time. Okay, just do these question answer from here. All right, now next page. Again, I'm zooming in so that the letters will be large and you can see very clearly. Okay, now, okay, so now next D question, why did the writer find TPT's nocturnal nature to be a drawback? Answer, the writer found TPT's nocturnal nature to be a drawback because it was most lively when it was time for ordinary people to be in bed. Okay, this is answer number D. Now answer number E question, why would TPT sometimes sneeze and splutter while drinking milk? Answer, TPT was much too ladylike to make any such fuss over her milk. She was usually in rather a hurry for it and consequently CONSEQUENTLY, consequently more of her face went into the saucer, 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 than was intended by nature, comma, with the result that a certain amount of liquid, 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 went up her nose and made TPT sneeze and splutter, SPLUTTER. Okay, again I'm repeating, TPT was much too lazy like to make any such fuss over her milk. She was usually in rather a hurry for it and consequently more of her face went into the saucer than was intended by nature, with the result that a certain amount of liquid went up her nose and made TPT sneeze and splutter, SPLUTTER. Done. Now next we will do. So F is, what would Tippity do when she felt there was trouble nearby? Answer: Tippity would make use of Brook's tail as hiding place when she felt there was trouble nearby. Okay, again I'm repeating. Tippity would make use of Brook's tail as hiding place when she felt there was some trouble nearby. Okay. Now question number G. What would she do when she became tired during the afternoon walks? Answer: when she became tired during the afternoon walks, she would make for the writer's leg and be up on his shoulder, or if Brock or John happened to be at hand, she would spring on to one of their backs and get a free ride. So just see this answer. Okay, again I'm just showing. So this is answer number G. Okay, this you can see here. Now H, what would she generally do after sunset? What effect did a good dinner have on her? Tippity was nocturnal and woke up a little after sunset. If left to herself, provided she didn't get a good dinner, she would be prepared to play and look about for odds and ends to nibble on all night through. Full stop. A good dinner had the effect of making her sleepy too. Okay, so she actually loves to eat. Okay, answer you can see. Just do it in your notebook. Okay, again I'm telling you, I'll just post these question answer on Snap homework also, so that if the things will not be clear, if anything is missing here, so that you can do from there. All right, next, read to info. Explain the phrase would have done credit to an animal 10 times her size. Answer: her growl was so alarming that it was equivalent to the growl of an animal 10 times bigger than her in size. Okay, equivalent, EQUIVALENT, equivalent. Okay, equal to. Okay, now question number 2. Why was it in the writer's interest to provide Tippity with a good dinner? Answer: it was in the writer's interest to provide Tippity with a good dinner because Tippity would invariably overeat, and that meant sleeping solidly till the early hours of the morning. This way writer would also get good night sleep. Okay, get good night sleep. So this was answer number 2, read to info. Okay, you can see here, just do it in your notebook. Okay, now I am zooming out this so that you can just see the answer. If something is missing, you can complete that. Okay, so these are the question answer, first and second question. Now you can see here. All right. Okay, now next, third question you can see. Again, I'm just zooming in. Give two example from the passage. Give two examples from the passage to show that Tippity was not very choosy when it came to eating. Answer: she would make her way to the extreme end of a branch and nibble off the young leaves. One day, second, she was quite happy on any tree or shrub and found something to eat on all. Okay, so this is answer number 3. Okay. Fourth, how do we know that Tippity wasn't too keen to accompany the writer on his afternoon strolls? Answer: Tippity accompanied the writer and the dogs on an afternoon stroll after being ruthlessly pulled out of her box. This shows that Tippity wasn't too keen to accompany the writer on his afternoon. Keen means interested. Okay, writing on his afternoon strolls. Okay, so this is answer number 4. You can see here, I'll show. Now question number 5. Why would Tippity get tied up before meals? How did this practice ultimately lead to her death? Answer: Tippity got tied up before meals because sometimes while jumping here and there, her tail may pass through the soup and spoil the taste. Full stop. She had been tied up just before dinner, but somehow the end of the chain had got unfastened from the leg of the chair. Full stop. She hopped about on the boards of the veranda and dragged her chain behind her. Full stop. There was a fox nearby who had poor Tippity in its relentless jaws. So this was the end of Tippity. Okay. Tippity got tied up before meals because sometimes while jumping here and there, her tail may pass through the soup and spoil the taste. She had been tied up just before dinner, but somehow the end of the chain had got unfastened from the leg of the chair. She hopped about on the boards of veranda and dragged her chain behind her. That there was a fox nearby who had poor Tippity in its relentless jaws. Okay, this is answer number 5. Okay, so now till here we will do. Alright, so complete the notes in your notebook. Again, I'm telling you, C part, discuss and write, we will not do. Okay, discuss and write, we will not do. Okay. We will do till here. Okay, question number 5. Now complete these in your notebook, and thank you so much for watching.